Starting October 18, Quebec will have its first right-wing government since the Union Nationale in 1970, bringing to power a political party that didn't exist until 7 years ago. When François Legault takes office as premier, the Coalition Avenir Québec promises to radically alter the province's course on immigration, the economy, education and more. Quebec's new political reality will be closely watched ahead of 2019's federal election, when Prime Minister Justin Trudeau runs for re-election with his provincial Liberal counterparts in a greatly weakened state, and the federal Conservatives hoping for a potential ally in Mr. Legault. Check back here in the coming weeks and months for the Globe and Mail's full coverage of what's going on. Mr. Legault is a millionaire airline executive who entered the National Assembly as a member of the Parti Québécois, serving in cabinet posts under Premiers Lucien Bouchard and Bernard Landry. In 2011, after a brief retirement from politics, he co-founded the CAQ, uniting former separatists and nationalists under one conservative banner. Mr. Legault is the premier designate until October 18, when he announces his cabinet and is sworn in by Lieutenant Governor Jean-Michel Doyen. Two likely candidates for cabinet posts are Simon Jolin Barrette, the CAQ's justice critic in opposition, and Genevieve Guilbeault, a former spokesperson for the provincial coroner's office who handled media relations during 2013's Lac Mégantic rail disaster. Reasonable accommodation, Quebec values, religious neutrality. The terms have changed over the years, but every Quebec governing party has at some point tried to legally enforce its own version of secularism, each time raising thorny questions about civil rights, systemic racism and Islamophobia. The Parti Québécois' Charter of Quebec Values, which prohibited public servants from wearing religious symbols such as niqabs or turbans, foundered in 2014 when the Marois government was voted out of office. The Liberals, in turn, passed Bill 62 in 2017, which barred Quebecers from wearing face coverings when using public services. That law was stalled in court before the province issued new guidelines shortly before the election. Now Mr. Legault plans to ban authority figures such as teachers, police officers, judges and bureaucrats from wearing religious garments, and he's willing to use the notwithstanding clause to shield such policies from constitutional challenges. Mr. Legault's team has mused about a compromise to let existing public servants continue wearing what they have been, but that would prohibit new hires from wearing religious symbols or clothing. More reading on religious symbols. Immigrants will have a harder time starting new lives in Quebec under a CAQ government. Mr. Legault promised to cut the annual quota by 10,000 people a year, and to subject newcomers to a Quebec values and French language test. During the campaign, Mr. Legault admitted some uncertainty about how those tests would work and whether immigrants could be expelled from Quebec for failing them. Regardless, the measures could spell trouble for businesses and municipalities competing with the rest of Canada to retain immigrants and fill urgent labor shortages. If you think Montreal is a laissez-faire haven of hedonism, you may think again once you try to smoke cannabis there. Mr. Legault wants Quebec to have Canada's highest legal minimum age for buying cannabis, 21, up from 18 as his predecessor had decided. The PQ would also bar Quebecers from smoking cannabis in all public places. Add to that Quebec's pre-existing ban on growing cannabis at home, and you have some of the most restrictive drug policies in the country. More reading on cannabis. Mr. Legault's fellow premiers have been increasingly restive about the Trudeau government's carbon tax, which aims to meet Canada's commitments under the 2015 Paris Climate Change Accord. Starting January 1, 2019, Ottawa can impose a minimum carbon price in any province without its own tax or cap-and-trade system, which Quebec has and which Mr. Legault plans to keep. That puts Mr. Legault on one side of a potentially messy legal battle between the provinces and Ottawa, Ontario, a former partner in the cap-and-trade regime with Quebec and California, backed out after Premier Doug Ford took office. While Alberta is putting its carbon tax on hold because of the Trans Mountain Pipeline dispute and Saskatchewan is fighting the carbon tax in court. Like his Ontario counterpart, Doug Ford, Mr. Legault ran for office on his business credentials, promising Quebecers a leaner and more fiscally conservative government. The economy he inherits is a fairly stable one, thanks in part to balanced budgets and highly unpopular social service cuts by his liberal predecessor. The CAC hopes to boost the finances even further by exporting more Hydro-Québec power and giving the province's investment arm more power to attract foreign capital. Here's a fuller look from business reporter Nicolas Van Praa at some of the economic challenges the CAC government faces. The night before Mr. Legault's election, Canada struck a new proposed trade deal with the Trump administration, ending 14 months of haggling over how to replace the North American Free Trade Agreement. In the United States-Mexico-Canada Agreement, USMCA, the Trudeau government made a big concession, opening 3.59% of Canada's protected dairy market to U.S. producers. That's alarmed farmers in Quebec, the largest dairy-producing province, who fear competition with cheaper American products will hurt their revenue and system of production quotas. Mr. Legault has promised to fight for farmers' interests, and Mr. Trudeau plans at some point to compensate the farmers for their losses. In the meantime, Canadian manufacturers are still hampered by U.S. tariffs on steel and aluminum, which the USMCA breakthrough did not resolve. Until 2018, the Liberals and Parti Québécois ruled Quebec for almost 50 years, staking out both sides of the sovereignty debate without fear of serious challenges from smaller parties. Now, after an election where Quebec independence wasn't an issue, the parties or shadows of their former selves, Premier Philippe Couillard's Liberals fell from 70 seats to 32, while the PQ lost official party status and its leader lost his seat. The far-left Quebec Solidaire is now the biggest sovereigntist bloc in the National Assembly, with 10 seats to the PQ's 9. For now, the Liberals are being led by former Cabinet Minister Pierre Arcan until they choose a permanent replacement for Mr. Couillard, who is retiring from politics.